and Tarakram. Now let us see the hand cricket. Okay, first let me run it, how it works. Okay, we are asked to choose a bat or ball first. I'm choosing ball 2 first. Okay, it is saying that show your hand on camera and hit the space bar to input. Okay. Here we are getting the bowling function here. Okay, now I am showing 5 and I am pressing space bar. Okay, it was an out. Now we should wait for batting function. Okay, now this is batting. Now we are batting. Same like before. I am showing 3 and pressing space bar. Now 2. 4. Okay, now if we observe here, our score was 4, and before if you observe, here it was displayed as a 5. It was computer's hand. Now up to now my total score is 9. Okay, let us play further. 4, 5, 3. Okay, it was a out. Both hands are maxed and it was a out. It says your winner. My score is 21 and computer's is 5. Okay, I'm winner now. Okay, now coming to code. Here we are importing the libraries that are required. CV2, media pipe, random and time. Okay, this media pipe here is to track our hand. Okay, now this random is for computer to select random. Okay, now time we are importing it. Okay. Here, bat and ball are initialized to 0 here. These all are the images of fingers which we saw before. Now those all images are being stored into an array called fingers. Okay, now this is a tracker function. We are basically having 3 functions, batting, bowling and tracking function, tracker function here. This tracker function tracks our hand position and it returns a value as a score. This score is being used by a function batting or bowling. Okay, now this tracker function, it mainly track our hand positions. Okay, now if you see this, okay, let me show you this. This is basically a hand landmark model. Now we are using the indexes like 8, 7 and comparing these two like 12, 11, 16, 15, 20, 19. Okay, if you see here, now this is for a thumb finger. Okay, if index 4 of x coordinate and x coordinate of index 3, we are comparing both those two. Now if we see here, x coordinate, basically if we go from left to right here, if x coordinate of 4 is more than 3, that is finger is closed, then it should be accounted as a 0, or else it should be open, then it should count as a 1. Similarly here, if the y coordinate of index 8 and y coordinate of index 7 are being compared. Okay, now y coordinate, it starts from the top left. Okay, now if y, it is measured from top to bottom. So if y coordinate of 8 is more than 7, it means like this is present under it. It means finger is closed. Then it should be 0, which says here, okay, val 2 is equal to 0 if its coordinate is greater than 7. or else finger is open, it should be accounted as a 1. Similarly, remaining all fingers. Finally, we are adding the open fingers all. Okay, now this is a code to it shows our hand, which we saw before. Okay, now coming to batting function. Okay, here we are loading our camera and setting its width and height. Okay, this is a drawing tool and this is hand tracking tool here. Okay, now this is while true loop, that is means it always flows through until the condition, until it comes out of loop here. Okay, here we use this tracker function and stored it in the variable called val. Okay, now here it says that if spacebar is pressed, then it takes the input. Like we saw before, our hand will be continuously showing, and when we hit the spacebar, then it accounts as an input. Now this line says that to choose computer a random choice from 1 to 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in them. Okay, it shows its choice on the left part of the screen. We can observe for a very less amount of time this image. Okay, now we are incrementing the variable of bat. If val is equal to computer, that means val is basically our hand and computer is basically this computer's hand. If both are equal, then it is treated as out and it comes out of the function and the function ends here, or else it shows the current score and all. It is a bat, like this is our hand and this is a computer's hand, and total score of our batting score. Okay, similarly bowling, the major difference between batting and bowling function is, like, in batting function score of our hand is counted, in bowling function score of computer hand is counted. This all process is same, except this bowl equal to bowl plus val. Similarly here also, if both are equal, then it is treated as out, or else it will be increasing variable bowl. Okay, finally this is it is our choice to bowl or bat first, which we saw that at first part of the code. If it is a bat, then it follows the order of batting and then bowling. If it is a bowl, it goes first with bowling and then batting. Okay, finally we are printing our score and computer score and comparing it and displaying the winner here. And finally we are closing all the open windows here. Okay, let me run once again. Now we can choose bat first. Okay, we should show our hand. Okay. Now at this part we can see our hand. See, I am displaying 5, it is also showing 5. Now 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0. 0 we are not using, but for safe we entered it. Okay, now I am pressing spacebar. Okay, now 4, pressing space. We can see here the total score is 4 here. Now 3, 2, 5. Okay, it is out. Now present our total score is 14. And now it's our turn to bowl. If you see here, we can observe for a very less part of time. Okay, I'm showing 5, 3, 2. Okay, it is a note. Again, we are the winner. Total bowling score is 10. Okay, 14 and 10, and we are the winner here. Thank you.